great friends. Suhel and I have studied in the same school, believe it or not. They make, Lamatnia makes different kinds of people. So, so with these few words, over to you, Suhel.
He was 4 years my senior. And I still don't dye my hair. That should say a thing about brands. But it is a truly eminent panel. You've got Kini with Coca-Cola, Mrs. Bachchan, Sunil Alagh, who was the CEO of Britannia until he fell in love with Nasli Wadia, who falls in love so easily. And then he fell out of Britannia. So let me begin by asking Mrs. Bachchan. You've spent, to my mind, the longest time in Bollywood. You're married to a man who personally I have a huge amount of regard for. You've built and engendered a family that is truly, as Harsh said, at the forefront of Bollywood. When you look at brands, what do you think has changed from the time you entered Bollywood and now?
Good evening. First, may I request this light to be put off because it's hitting me in the eye. This one. Wo peeli wali jo light hai na, niche. Aankh mein aa rahi hai aapke.
In Delhi, it's called the Modi light. I'm incorrigible.
Thank you, Suhel. A wonderful question. You are asking the wrong person because if you talk about brands from a family, I'm one brand which is not really a brand. But
actually, you are a brand. In many ways. You're a better actor than everyone else in your family. You are the only wife that Mr. Bachchan has. You're the only mother that Shweta and Nikhil have. You're the best brand. I mean, you are inarguably the finest brand. But when you look at how India has evolved, how do you feel brands have taken their place in society and how Bollywood is looking at brands?
I think Bollywood is not looking at brands. They're making the money. Brands are looking at them. I think that branding is something that has changed over the years. When we were children, at least when I was a child, a brand meant that's what it was. Biscuit meant Britannia. Cola meant Coca-Cola. Chocolate meant Cadbury's. There was no other alternative. But today it has changed. There are many alternatives. And you have to build a story and convince people how this alternative is better than all that one has lived with for the last 40, 50, 60 years.
You know, Kini, it's an interesting point that Mrs. Bachchan makes. I, as a marketer, have always believed consumers don't buy brands, they buy benefits. You head Coca-Cola, Harsh talked about it, it's unarguably the world's most recognized phrase after hello. What do you believe makes a brand more exciting? So Kini, that's to you.
Thanks for the question, and I know that you probably could answer that better than I can, but I'll give it my best shot. If you look at Coke, I mean, we've been around for 130 years. And the biggest challenge with a brand, as Mrs. Bachchan just said, is How do you stay relevant generation after generation? Every generation, new brands come in, new companies come in, and staying relevant and exciting is the biggest challenge for a brand, especially for a brand like ours, which for 130 years we haven't changed the logo, we haven't changed the packaging design, and we haven't changed the product. It's exactly the same for 130 years. So the excitement comes from everything we do around it, whether it be the advertising, but actually more than the advertising, it's what's called cultural relevance. One example is Coke Studio, which started off as an alternative music platform in Brazil, and then moved to Pakistan, where it became almost a cult following. And now we have Coke Studio in 34 countries. And I know there still is a debate out here whether Pakistan Coke Studio is better or India, but we are only season 4 and they're season 9, so I guess they've had a 5-year head start. But the great thing about Coke Studio is it's made Coke brand relevant to a whole new generation of people in each of the countries where it operates. And that's how the brand stays relevant and exciting. So that's one example, but there'll be more. Yeah.
Sunil. Sorry, please.
May I just?
Please.
You know what is very interesting? Is how you have also kept up with times. You've gone to Zero Coke and you've gone to... I think that's very important.
Yeah. Why did Aishwarya advertise for Pepsi?
She was on brand
it's
Coke.
Such
she
a
was,
poor
she
drink.
Was not a Bachchan then.
Brilliant! See, I told you! She's the brightest in that family. Only Ficky recognizes it. If it was CII, they would have invited Mr. Bachchan. Anyway, I won't go there. Sunil, you, until you fell out of love and other things with Nasli Wadia, you ran Britannia brilliantly, or so we've been told. You introduced various brands, but to my mind, what you did was you change the imprint of consumption. How do you believe brands from the time you started in ITC till now have evolved in India?
I'm a little confused myself, because if you go to Google and today you punch in the word brand, you'll get over 1 billion responses. Okay? So it shows that everyone has an opinion on what a brand is today. Compared to the times that Jayaji was saying, like today, everybody will say this movie is bad, that acting is bad, without going into who directed, nothing. Everyone is an authority on an ad. Everyone is an authority on a brand. And that's the big change which is taking place. And I disagree with a number of people. In fact, Harsh got up and said, whether it's a product, whether it's whatever. I think a person, a human being, a product can never become a brand. According to me, and I'm just being...
So is Narendra Modi not a brand?
No, he's not. He's not. Let me just give you an answer to that, what I'm talking about. For India, sure. Suhel said
you'll lose your speaking job on television very soon.
What do you do with a man
he's
like him?
He's unarguably the finest brand in the world.
No, let me define what a brand is, for instance. And I'll give you, all of you, to try. And I'm going to read this out. You tell me, 37 years old, cavalier attitude towards death, unchanged since 1953. Expressions have changed since 1962. Who is this? Is James Bond? Is Sean Connery a brand? No. Is Craig a brand? No. It's an idea that is the brand today. It is no longer you talking about a name or a human being. For instance, if you take even Mahatma Gandhi, it is his idea that lives after him. If a person becomes a brand and if the brand dies with him, what is the point of that brand? So it's an idea.
Today no, that's a great thing.
You know, it's an
so
idea. That.
So what is Kejriwal's brand? Kejriwal or anarchy? No, I'm asking.
Yeah, all right. So as far as I'm concerned, it's the idea that Kejriwal started with by saying, I'm going to represent everybody. And that idea has died and the brand will die with it.
That's you mean he'll die?
Yeah. No, the brand will die. With
oh, the brand will die.
Because he's not a brand. Now, I will even take a name. If you take Hutchison Max, then you take Hutch, then you take Orange, then you take Vodafone. The name has changed. But has that idea changed or what it does? Does it? So you live today for the idea. Coke tried to change, even though he says it's unchanged. They fell flat on their face when they tried to change and became, and they had to go back to classic Coke when they tried to compete with Pepsi and became a new idea. So the important thing is, as Jayaji was saying, you have an idea, you don't change that idea, but you remain contemporary with it. That is a brand, according to me, and not a product or a name or a human being or anything like that. So what does anyone, even if you take Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, he's the angry young, the idea is the angry young man. It is not Mr. Bachchan who's the brand, it is the idea of the young and the angry young man that carries it forward. So if you are building a brand, you have to make sure that the idea is consistent and yet it remains contemporary, and that's when you build a brand, according to me. But it's
Sunil,
a worthwhile discussion.
I think
Sunil,
old age has really affected you.
I think that what you're saying is right. But you know, what happens is there are certain people, when they endorse a brand, you don't really have to work very hard to convince the market.
Right. So what they become are brand ambassadors. They are not the brand. That's the question I'm asking everybody is, do not confuse being a brand ambassador to the brand.
Okay, since you're
That's
so
all.
Bright.
I'm not bright. You are the one
What's
who's
your
bright.
Definition of a brand?
I'm saying that. It's an idea that has to last out, and you have to be contemporary for it. You have to remain and you change. Coke, Coke Zero, Coke X, Coke Y, Coke whatever. It is moving on with the younger generation and the brand stays alive. The idea of Coke stays alive. If you stay where you are...
So what's the idea of Coke?
So
everything, so you tell us.
You're telling me?
Yeah.
I charge.
I know, but this is free.
Thanks. I'm not going to
Thanks
give it
for
Harsh,
free.
Harsh will give you three kachoris and invite you to Ragmari next year.
Why should I tell Coke it's for free?
Okay, Kini, he's just destroyed everything you guys have done for 130 years. How do you deal with a biscuit maker?
So now you know why he's not consulting for us, right?
The way to deal with a biscuit maker is to wait, you make Bombay die.
I don't want to get there because he's already spent 3,000 crores defaming someone. I don't want to go there. Kini.
So I'd probably disagree with Sunil on this one. Brand is not just an idea. A brand is a combination of an idea that's embodied in a product and a name and a visual identity. So a brand essentially is like a shorthand. A shorthand for a bunch of ideas in the consumer's head about something. So, for instance, whether it's a human being or whether it's a political party or whether it's a product like ours, when a consumer sees a red can with the Coca-Cola logo on it, they immediately trigger associations of quality, great taste, and a whole host of other ideas that are in their mind. But those ideas are associated with a product, a package, and a logo, and the color red. If you take away the color red, and I were to suddenly put a blue-colored Coke on the shelf, the consumer is going to get completely confused and will not
but
trust
got
the brand
a black,
anymore.
You got a black zero Coke? How are you dealing with that?
But it's Coke Zero.
Yeah, but all yeah. right. So that's exactly what I'm saying.
So you build ideas around it. So
no discussion colors. Between panelists. This is not the news hour.
And you're not Arnab.
I never will be Arnab. I speak perfect English. Go on, Kini, complete. Sorry for the interruptions from the BJP, from Sunil Alagh.
Excuse me.
Joking,
yeah. He's BJP as well, by the way. Huh?
I hate them. Let it go on record. Actually, let it not, because Fiki will be banned. Go ahead.
Yeah,
now, can you finish that?
So I said, let it go on record that I don't know those two people on that side. my point is, and you know, again, reacting to what Sunil said, but essentially, every time you make a change to a brand, whether it, you know, rename a brand or come up with a new visual identity system, you have to invest a lot of money, time, and effort, and energy in getting the consumer to think about the brand differently. So tomorrow, if you wanted to, like, you know, we launched Coke Zero, launching a black can with Coke required a lot of effort to explain to people it's your old Coke but without the sugar. And getting people to associate with that black can is a lot of effort.
Okay, can you, I just raise, sorry.
Sunil, when he said that when you change, you have to spend a lot of money to build the brand. So when you said that there are brand ambassadors, they're not brands. So you need somebody who becomes the ambassador to brand the brand. So they are brands. Right.
So I agree with you that, look, you can have a Dhoni who is there first. Now Virat Kohli takes over. Somebody else takes over. The brand idea doesn't change. The ambassadors change. So do
but
not.
But you're talking make about people who are not permanent.
I am.
You are.
Now I'm talking about James Bond.
Here is a product.
Let's take Bond. Mm-hmm. Sean Connery is. Would you say is the idea of Bond a brand, or is it Sean Connery or Craig or whoever has played Bond over the years? The concept, no matter which brand ambassador has taken it forward, the concept of Bond was he's not afraid of death. He's a carefree attitude. That mustn't change regardless of who you have speaking for the brand.
No, Sunil, if I may step in.
Sure. That's the point.
Because out of respect for your age, I didn't want to earlier, but I must now. An idea is known through its implementation. Others' ideas exist in space. I think the point Mrs. Bachchan and Kini were making is ideas are reflected in the way they engage with the consumer. A Coke Zero engages with the consumer, as Jayaji said, a Mr. Bachchan engages with Indians today. And I disagree with you, Sunil. He's no longer the angry young man. For many, he's the loved man. For many, he's the respected man. So I think with relevance also comes to my mind a certain amount of change. An idea always lives through its execution. I mean, otherwise, what else is an idea?
But I'm not disagreeing with you.
You shouldn't. I'm moderating the goddamn session.
Arnab Goswami at his best.
No, it's Arnab Goswami speaking in English.
You disagree with him, you've had it. Look, all I'm saying is, earlier, if you want me to come up with my final point on it, is that, look, earlier, from a manufacturer's point of view, there was a brand. You had only one stakeholder, he became the legal owner of it. Today, you have many stakeholders of your brand, and therefore, you have to now interact with them, and there's a legal owner, and there's a psychological owner. And the idea that I'm talking about is that once you become the legal owner of an idea, you have to make sure that all the new stakeholders that are with you continue to accept you as the idea. So that is the change. Earlier, I own the brand, I do what with it. Today, you have to interact with all the stakeholders.
But how does a brand happen? Yeah. How does a brand happen?
No, one second. So we are getting into how to create a brand now. No. So the question that you're asking is a very valid one.
She's asking a much deeper question. You have to understand. See, the problem is, everything is not Times Now. This is BBC asking you.
You explain what she was asking, since I never understood her.
It was in English, that's why I will repeat.
One second.
It said, how does a brand happen?
How does it happen?
In terms of not its creation.
Then?
How does it endure? It's E-N-D-U-R-E.
Right, so what am I saying?
You're saying the same thing, but I'm just moderating.
Now I wanted to. You're saying the same thing, but I'm wondering how to put it another way.
Why are you attacking me?
I'm not attacking you.
I'm like Hamid Ansari. I have nothing to do. I mean, in a matter of speaking. Yes, Jayaji, please continue.
Why don't you ask a question of how does the brand die? If you are talking about a brand
A brand that dies is not a brand.
No, there are brands that have been there for about 50 years and suddenly die. What is that? It'd be an interesting discussion to have.
That is,
how did a brand die?
If cycles go out of fashion, then Atlas is not relevant.
Brilliant. No, Sunil, yeah. I must come in.
I mean,
brands die if they lose relevance and benefit value to consumers.
So it's the experience that you have to make sure. And now I'm hoping that some words of English will register on you also. But it is experience that I'm talking
some
about.
Some words in the, English. Yeah, so of English is incorrect grammar.
Yeah, all right, very good. So all I'm saying is the experience was today a brand is created because of the experience that the consumer has of your brand.
So fair.
That's all.
Kini, you being the head of Coca-Cola here, having worked in Atlanta, how do you feel or how do you believe consumer experiences over the years have changed? Is there greater consumer demand? Is there greater consumer probity? Is there greater corporate transparency? What's changed in the marketplace?
Well, if you look at the world today essentially has become almost seamless in terms of information. So consumers are getting far more information about brands from all over, and whether it be social media, which often isn't always the best source of information, but then that's where people get a lot of their information about brands. And consumers have opinions and they express opinions to the point where, you know, a funny incident globally is our global Facebook page for Coke, which is one of the most followed pages on Facebook, wasn't started off by Coke. It was started off by a bunch of Coke fans who set it up, and it got so many likes that eventually it became the official Facebook page for Coke. So today, consumers are increasingly taking ownership for brands and the expression of brands to a point where many manufacturers and brand owners have to co-create the brand or co-innovate on the brand with consumers.
That's what I've been saying.
Jaiji, you raised an important point about brand ambassadors. There's this silly debate in the government saying brand ambassadors must be penalized for any brand malfunctions.
Rubbish.
You know, if a brand doesn't perform, blah, blah.
That's
agree with
rubbish.
You. But since when has the government done anything right? Most governments, including Samajwadi, BSP. You're not from BSP. That's why I said BSP. But tell me, how can governments make brand ambassadors accountable when they're not actually involved in the marketing of the brand?
I think they probably don't have the right advisors.
Sorry, Sunil. Another blow.
I'm not talking about a blow. See, the question is that the debate that is taking place, and I am partly agreeing and not agreeing. Now, for instance, if you put a brand up and an ambassador up and say, please buy this flat. And you know that the builder, see, if you, nobody will know how Maggie noodles are made or how Coke is made. So if you're using that brand, you're not supposed to go into the factory and do it. But if a brand ambassador says, buy a flat without him doing due diligence on the builder, and everybody says, oh, Mr. Shah Rukh Khan is buying a flat there, so I'm going to buy it. Then you penalize the guy because there's an opportunity there because he's being
no,
paid.
But why? One second. How stupid are you to buy a flat because Shah Rukh is buying a flat?
Suhel, I don't think anybody buys a flat, no matter who is the brand ambassador or who endorses it. I mean, flat is something that you definitely don't buy. That, I mean, the builder uses whoever to give himself some kind of importance and to say, I matter. I am using Shah Rukh or I am using Amitabh or I am using whoever. I don't think building is the right, construction is the right example, Sunil. Maybe you can give another example.
No. Why I'm giving that example is because today when you go and not the people out here who buy it, if you talk an average person who's in a small town, and you're not talking about buying a house in Juhu, which nobody will believe anyone till they do the due diligence. But a lot of people for small housing societies, right, and the average person says, I'm not talking about Mr. Bachchan or Shah Rukh Khan, no, or someone, I've just taken a name, but they better do some diligence, not they. I don't mean by Mr. Bachchan. But if you are suddenly telling that, all right, why is the builder then using you if he thinks it's not going to impact the consumer? Then the builder is wasting money. He knows that you impact the consumer, and that is why he uses you.
Okay, let's because we have very limited time. Let's go back to a core issue. Yeah. Hello.
No, that.
Let's go back to a core issue. Do you believe Do you believe the business of building brands has become more expensive?
Don't interrupt when two sensible people are talking.
I know, that's why I interrupted. That's why I interrupted. Now you figure it out. No, but on a serious note, do you believe, and this is a question for all three of you, do you believe the business of building brands has become more complex given the diversity of India, given the enormous expense involved, and given the competition?
You know, I come back in one line. Earlier, it was owned by one, and as I was saying, and then Kini repeated it, today, everybody, every stakeholder, you have millions of stakeholders in your brand. So you better be sure of what you are doing today. You have to interact, you have to do various things, where earlier, you could sit in your office and say, this is my brand, and you move forward. So even the case of Britannia, when we had to rebrand it, for instance, was when we came up with the line, eat healthy, think better. Now, everyone was telling me, who will understand a line like that, eat healthy, think better and all, but you go to the Indian culture and you say that if your stomach is right, you will think better. Swasth khao, tan man jagao, which we translated. And everyone from Nestle down came to me and said, why didn't we think of it? So you have to capture the psychological moment and keep evolving with it, because you are the legal owner. Make sure that the psychological ownership stays with your consumer and be in touch with him so that you are able to move along with him.
So that's an interesting thing. And Jayaji, I'd like you to comment on this. Sunil's point is there needs to be psychological and emotional connects with consumers. Do you believe it's getting even more complex given language, given regionalism, all these issues? Is it becoming more complex to build brands in India?
Well, I'm not a marketing bhaj, so it's very difficult for me to say anything about it. I'd rather trust what Sunil is saying, since
you would.
Yes. But we're talking brands.
Good. I want to.
Sometimes when I look at the advertisements, not for very major, big, established companies, but the medium and the other chota motas, I don't take it seriously. It's not serious for me. So I differ where Sunil is saying that the people who endorse are not brands, because if you're not a brand, you can't endorse. Nobody will ask you to come and endorse.
You become the brand ambassador. I'm agreeing with you on that.
No, she's right.
I mean,
you will never endorse a biscuit. If Mr. Bachchan endorses it, it will be eaten. That's what she's saying, but she's polite not to say it in so many words.
It's when you're talking about emotional contact, and you have to have emotional contact with your market, with your buyers. How do you provide that emotion? Not only through the script, also through your narrator.
So,
and how convincingly your narrator narrates it to the people. You know, I mean, there are two ways of drinking Coca-Cola. One is just good, finished. One is...
You should use her.
I
don't know, you guys are bloody wasting your time with this.
You're right. We'll have a conversation after this, ma'am.
I must tell you that I made a comment about Aishwarya was not a Bachchan then, but I must tell you that even my husband endorsed Pepsi for a short while. So I just wanted to correct that.
So
I feel that I differ with Sunil there, because I'm not interested in getting somebody to endorse my brand who's not a brand. Abhi main us brand ko build karun, phir unko kahun aaiye ji aap hamare brand ko sell kariye. Why should I?
Okay.
There has to be emotional contact and psychological contact.
But Jayaji, let me tell you, personally, I've written about it, spoken about it. I'm a great believer in not using celebrities for endorsement for two reasons. Number one, if something happens to the celebrity, it has an immediate fallout on the brand. Number two, if the brand gives benefits which are enduring, valuable, and rewarding, I wouldn't need a celebrity. But let's put the question to Kini. Coca-Cola in the past, no longer, has used celebrities to endorse the brand. Kini, given what you've seen across the world, from Atlanta to Delhi, do you believe that the Indian market has evolved where you don't necessarily need a brand endorser in order to plug your brand if you can get the benefits transmitted?
You're wrong.
No, that I always am. That's why I haven't married. Why have a woman tell you every evening?
Swell. I think they may not use a brand ambassador, as Suhel said, or they may not use another brand because they think they're bigger than the brand who's going to endorse their brand. So, but today they are advertising differently. You see a television serial, you go to see a movie, you'll see a bottle of Coke. That's not endorsement. Of course they're endorsing. I mean, it's being done in every television serial. India started it now. The West started earlier. In a movie, everything is branded, used. So they have changed their style, but they are branding.
So you're saying product placement in many ways is a tangential avatar of...
Of course.
So Kini, let's have your thoughts on this. Before we open it out to Q&A.
So Suhel, there's no rule about this. Because the reality is you can create brands with or without brand endorsements. Ultimately, it boils down to your creative idea. And I'll give an example on Thumbs Up. We've always used a brand ambassador. Because the idea of Thumbs Up is it appeals to the macho hero in you. And using a brand ambassador who embodies that spirit of... strength and masculinity is what's worked for the brand. For other brands, like Sprite, for instance, we rarely ever use, in fact, we never use brand ambassadors for Sprite because Sprite is all about a different brand idea. It's about clarity and cut-through thinking. So each brand has to decide whether there is a need or a role for a brand ambassador in its advertising. And there may be periods in its lifetime where it needs a brand ambassador, and there may be periods where it doesn't need a brand ambassador. So there is no hard and fast rule about this. I would say every campaign, you start first with the idea, and then you decide, does a brand ambassador fit?
So I think that's an interesting point at which one can invite questions.
Mr. Kini is trying to say that you introduce the brand and then maybe you can get somebody to endorse it. So that means, again, authenticate the brand or support the brand. I mean...
You're right.
I hope so.
We'll open it out to questions. My one request... If you want to give us your biography, you can do it at the FICCI AGM next year. Ask a question in a pithy manner, almost as your brain was demonetized. And then we shall answer the question in a cashless manner, without any pain. There's a lady in the second row. There are many, but there's... There are many attractive... I didn't want to make a faux pas again.
So my question is for the whole panel. Was Pierce Brosnan trying to regain his importance by appearing in the Paan Bahar ad, or was it the other way around?
Who eats Paan Bahar? It's a banned product, isn't it?
So that's what... Was it Paan Bahar?
I hope he's not a member of FICCI. No, are they members of FICCI? No,
I'm 100% sure that it was Paan Bahar and not Pierce Brosnan.
There you are.
Who wanted Pierce Brosnan? I don't think he even knew about the product. Sorry?
Money, darling.
He made a lot of money.
He'll get more out of Paan Parag than he'll get out of James Bond.
But I just want to build on that to say that it's actually quite common for Hollywood actors to appear for brands in international markets. And they often don't even know much about the products that they're endorsing. And if you go to Japan, you'll find a lot of Hollywood actors appearing for brands as endorsers. And, I think Pierce Brosnan obviously didn't know very much about this brand.
I
One minute. I'm from Calcutta. Ladies always get preference in everything.
Thank you. I'm also from Calcutta.
It shows.
Thank you so much. My question is for Mrs. Bachchan. Ma'am, you debuted as a teenager in Satyajit Ray's Mahanagar, and Ray, to my understanding, till today remains a brand, a global brand for the cinema that he represented. Do you think one of the reasons why Indian cinema has really not been able to reach a global stature, the global ranking, is because we have not been able to reproduce another maybe Ray or a Steven Spielberg or a James Cameron?
It's a long answer, so I'm going to try and cut it short. I disagree with you as far as calling Satyajit Ray a brand. He's not a brand. He never was. But I think that India as a country is the brand, and all international filmmakers and production houses are coming into India to make films. Maybe our actors are not that many, or our directors are that many who are going out, very limited, because according to me, I think there's a color bias.
Interesting. Yes.
I mean, I think so.
That gentleman
I mean, if
Karol
Suhel, all big actors, male and female, have been offered films from the West, and they always tell you to play either an Arab or an Indian, yeah, or but never,
so
never
right.
An American or English person.
I'm waiting for Sunil Alagh to replace Clint Eastwood. In a film, not in a cemetery. Yes, sir.
Dirty Harry.
Well, that would be appropriate.
Sir, my name is Karandeep Mundre, and one of the businesses I run is a public relations firm. My question is especially to you, sir. How has public relations as an industry been affected by the change in brands, and how is there a change in the way you handle PR in the current scenario? Or has it been the same? I just want you to comment on brands and public relations.
You.
He's asking you.
I didn't see Dilip Cherian or Neera Radia here. I don't know about PR.
Someone's dared to question Suhel.
No, not question me. Question me on something, say intelligent, but logic. To be fair, and this is for political parties, it's for brands, it's for everyone. Public relations, as was seen earlier, has gone through a tremendous shift. I don't call it public relations, I call it galvanizing public opinion. Galvanizing public opinion is not the same thing as wining dining journalists. It's not the same as putting out your statement. I mean, take for example, some of the political events that have happened. Demonetization. To my mind, it's a public relations disaster. A lot of the media houses say, oh, it's a great thing, people are loving it. People. If there is confusion, there is never clarity. That, to my mind, is a PR disaster. There was a comment made by a very young, dynamic political individual about an earthquake. Nothing happened. So to my mind, that was also a public relations disaster. You don't promise a tsunami and then leave the room. Having said all of this, I think brands in India today are getting wrapped on the knuckles if their public engagement is despicable. Social media makes them more and more accountable. I've seen more brands apologize on social media than ever before. In this demonetization thing, Axis Bank, for one, some other banks have been wrapped on the knuckles. They've had to take to social media to apologize to their consumers. What does it mean? Public relations has moved from the guy managing the relation to the guy wanting the relation. And the guy wanting the relation is the consumer, and not the guy who's managing it.
Very nice. Well said, Suhel.
Yes, my friend. side. I will never forget you.
Thank you.
But he always begins with the right and then moves to the left.
Correct.
I'm touching on two things, and very short. And no bias, I assure you. Except my name. Can I say that?
Yeah, yeah. Now, you know, okay. You're behaving like Bernard Shaw. Your preface is longer than your play. Come on.
Anyway, B.B. Nagpal here. I'm a journalist.
Nagpal's up.
I'm a journalist. And just two things. One was a one-liner from Mr. Kini. From what I understand, what you said last, you said that each first you think of an idea, and then you decide whether it needs a brand ambassador or not. And if it doesn't need a brand ambassador, you will not take a brand ambassador, as in the case of Sprite.
No, he knows what he said. What's the question?
Please do not mind, Suhel, but when you retort...
Yeah, we are running short of time.
You confuse the whole thing.
Because you're a journalist doesn't mean you have to put you on a pedestal. Come on.
Jayaji, my question to you, I was trying to get that clear. Whether that was what he meant.
How did I know Nagpal?
Okay, Jayaji, aapse sawal ye hai. My question, very short question.
Ignore it.
Very short question. Suhel raised a question, your answer was nonsense. I'm now going back to that question. The government is thinking of saying that brand ambassadors should be held responsible for anything that if a brand is found to be faulty in some way, the brand ambassador would be equally responsible. I want your comment.
I said nonsense. What more comment?
And what was the question? Bhai, eh
main tuhanu kehna na Nagpal saab, tusi na jadon question karde ho te pyar naal karo na, direct karo. Puri Mahabharat kithe gaya Krishna, kithe gaya ho? Don't be an Advani in a fikhi. Yes, my young friend.
Hello. My question is to Mr. Kini. So Coca-Cola has always projected Pepsi as a company that has copied Coca-Cola and its product line to a large extent. But in 1985, Coke changed its original formula and made a new Coke.
Yeah, we know. What's the question?
So the question is, why would Coke change their formula and make it similar to Pepsi?
So can I tell you, we went to school in Calcutta.
Yes.
There was something called Precy. P-R-E-C-I-S. Keep your questions precied. Pithy. Come, Kini, answer.
All right.
And you can sit.
Two answers. One, we've never positioned Pepsi in any way because their competition, we focus on positioning ourselves. Yes, in the 1980s, there was a belief in the company that we needed to change the formula of Coke because we thought that consumers, our growth had slowed down, and we thought the reason the growth had slowed down is because consumers didn't like the taste of Coke anymore, and we were looking for something new. And of course, a group of very intelligent marketeers, consultants, and a bunch of other people thought that we should just make the product taste better. And so we went to consumers and we researched it and we came back with a product that we thought tasted better. But when we changed the taste, consumers' reaction was incredibly negative because to the point we've been saying all this time, for them the idea of Coke was the original. It didn't matter that the taste was one or the other. They wanted the original taste and they didn't care whether we came out and said, no, you know, it tastes better for you. So it was nothing to do, I would say, with Pepsi or competition. It was more to do with our own belief that to make the brand grow faster, we needed to change the taste. And we realized that the brand was owned by the consumers as much as we were, as much as by us. And we came back to the original taste. And even now, since then, we've tripled the size of the brand since then, and it's still growing.
They didn't try the desi style with namak and nibu.
You know,
no, but Kini has given a good Dr. Manmohan Singh answer.
One minute, Jayaji. There's a guy in Calcutta called Maya Ram. He sells pav bhaji and masala thumbs up and masala coke, which taste heavenly. Yes, there's a question there. Yes, my Jitendra friend. They're all my young children. If I had children by now, he'd be that old. But certainly not looking like that, I hope.
I have a question for Kini, sir. You have Coke as your brand and other products you launch, all your products like Sprite and all, everything is being launched outside India. So Thumbs Up is a super product that we in, Indians, we enjoy. So why don't you launch Thumbs Up outside India?
Thank you.
So take Thumbs Up to Trump.
thank you for that question and
because a lot of Indians.
Yeah, listen, say, listen. He's understood. Yeah. Yeah. He's running Coca-Cola. You're wearing a white jacket. You sit down. He'll answer your question. I don't want to sound like Sumitra, but sit down. Better.
Yeah, we would love to have a global brand come out of India. And Thumbs Up has typically found appeal mostly with the Indian, overseas Indians who've gone overseas. And that's not a large enough market to justify launching the brand outside of India. We need a brand that has global appeal in taste and brand idea that can emerge from India. And who knows, it may be Thumbs Up, it may be something else. We still haven't found that one thing that we think can scale globally from India. Interestingly, we've scaled global brands out of China and out of Japan. I think the next should be India.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
I would we talked about brand and brand ambassador and PR.
Everyone
and
doesn't know you're Pierce Brosnan, so tell them your name.
No, I would like to ask that how important is packaging for the brand? I think that's what.
Oh, naate bolo ya, thoda na ki hai.
Sanjay Bhatia.
I say that, na. Everyone doesn't know you.
No, you said Mayawati no biodata.
But that doesn't mean no nomenclature.
Okay.
Sunil, I'll ask you to take this one.
No, but you know, like I was, you're talking about packaging. If you take anything out by itself, sometimes it works, but you have to have what I call complete packaging. Now, for instance, Paperboat, which you are drinking today, has worked on packaging. The same drink has taken off on packaging. It's not common for all products. So the question that I wanted to ask everyone around here is that two brands have come up, Coke and Pepsi. Forget about the packaging, blue, red, black, whatever it is. How many people actually, therefore, is distribution the most important thing? Because every time you walk into a place and you ask for Coke, he said, nahi hai Pepsi, chalo pee lete. So two big brands are so easily replaceable that what are they going to do unless the distribution is not there? So where is the question of saying, oh, you ask for a Pepsi and say, nahi hai Coke? How many of us actually move out to say, I'm not going to drink this, I'm going to move forward? So that key thing which nobody is asking about is how is the distribution and easy availability so important rather than just the brand?
Okay, last question.
Interesting point. I sense that apart from the relevance of the benefit of the value of the brand and the idea behind it, it's important that
relevance of the value of the benefit of the brand. That's what you just said.
Okay. Let me correct it then. There is consensus in the panel that for a brand to be relevant for long, it must have benefit idea as well as continuity of acceptance by the client. I believe there is another variant important to preserve the brand, and that is the company which owns the brand must follow ethics, governance, and responsible leadership norms. What do you think would happen to Apple because they tried to save taxes, and I think there was a lot of criticism about them?
I love Apple.
The brand or the food?
Who's the question for?
I love both Apple, fruit, Adam, and Eve. And their sinful relationship. I think it has augured well for the world. And on that Apple note, I must call the session to an end. We have only 23 seconds left. We have a very eminent political panel. Thank you to Mrs. Bachchan, to Venkatesh Kini, to Sunil Alagh. Thank you, Harsh. Mr. Didar Singh for actually putting together a brand panel. And I have to say this, I haven't been paid by Fiki yet. But to my mind, several years ago, Fiki redesigned not just its logo, but its soul. It recalibrated what it would mean to people. And I remember telling Jyoti Suri and her colleagues that it's a great step forward. To my mind, that's branding in continuity. That's branding for relevance and branding for endurance. Have a splendid evening. Listen to the very bright people who are going to follow them. And have a great evening.